Greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to all the ardent listeners of Sajiva Vahini. Our topic for today is a fulfilled life. Few hours in hot summer, working hard makes us extremely thirsty and hungry. And if a friend comes by with a biryani parcel and a coke, and we think what else we need in life, and after finishing meal, we are content. Here, our stomach is full and we are satisfied. There is a spiritual appetite which was created when Adam disobeyed God in the Garden of Eden. That's the reason why all through our lives we try and fill that void with our own achievements, wealth, success, fame in our respective careers. People are running after earning wealth, hoping to have a fulfilled life. Let me remind you, friends, money can buy a house, but not home. People, but not affection. Medicines, but not health. A sleep well mattress, but not sleep. Sleeping pills, but not peace of mind. Bible says, "Blessed are they that hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be fulfilled." In Old Testament, blessing would manifest only when people would follow the Ten Commandments. If not, specific animal had to be sacrificed before everyone. Which means, if you carry an ox, people would know exactly what sin you have committed. How many of you are thanking God right now that you are in the new covenant? Me as well. Let's see why it's important to have proper understanding of what righteousness is. Just like Jesus, who was made a sinner without sinning, we have been made righteous without doing right. Yes, you heard it right, without doing right. We have been brought up in such an education system. It says, you got to do this and that, only then you will achieve something in life. But this is not what Bible says. For if by one man's offense death reigned through one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and gift of righteousness will reign in life through the one, Jesus Christ. Yes, we have not done anything to earn the gift of righteousness apart from accepting Lord Jesus as our Savior. We hear people praying this way, "Lord, I have given to poor, been good to everyone. I think you should start blessing me now." We see the manifestation of the blessing only when we look at the perfect finished work of Jesus Christ and not by our own good works. Understanding righteousness helps us to be mature and reign in life. Only then we will be completely satisfied. It helps us to have righteous conscience than having sin conscience. It doesn't mean we can sin more, but with a righteous conscience, you are with a mindset to have a right standing with God rather than thinking what could go wrong. The following scripture says, we triumph over sin with this gift of righteousness. Romans 5 says, for the sin of this one man Adam caused death to rule over many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and his gift of righteousness. For all who receive it will live in triumph over sin and death through this one man, Jesus Christ. The people who know their God shall do great exploits. You know what great exploits are? Jaw-dropping success. People start celebrating you for exceptional achievements. your enemies will start agreeing with you. History is going to record your remarkable works. Did you realize all of this you can achieve only by knowing your Creator and not by doing something? Only with Jesus as our foundation, we can reign and have a fulfilled life. Can you start this wonderful journey by accepting Jesus as Lord of your life? May the Holy Spirit God help all of us to walk in this revelation. Amen. God bless you.